Hi! Welcome to Flights of Fancy Storytime. I'm Anne from the National Air and Space Museum, and I'm here to bring some of our museum stories to you. Today I'm thinking about moons. Our planet has one moon that orbits around us. The Earth and the moon orbit together around the sun. I love to look at our moon in the sky, but did you know that other planets also have moons orbiting around them? In our Exploring the Planets gallery at the museum in Washington, D.C., we have a big model of the solar system and information about the moons as well as the planets. There are more than 200 moons orbiting around planets in our solar system. Some planets like Mercury and Venus have no moons at all, but some have more than Earth. What makes them moons is that they orbit around the planet that orbits around the sun. The system of planets and moons is kind of like the planet's family. Here's a story about that. Luna, the Earth's moon, is feeling lonely. Luna gets lots of attention from Earth and knows that Earth loves Luna very much, but Luna is all alone orbiting Earth. She knows that other planets have bigger families and sometimes wishes there were other moons in the Earth family with Luna. Luna can see Mars with two little moons. The moons of Mars are named Deimos and Phobos. The two little moons are very close to Mars. They're very active and move at different speeds. That seems fun, but they don't always seem to get along. "Hi, Luna," calls Phobos. "I'm a mighty moon," calls Deimos. "I'm a mighty moon," yells Phobos. Luna says, "Yes, you're both mighty. Bye, Phobos. Bye, Deimos." They are fun neighbors, but that does not seem like the right kind of family for Luna. Luna's not sure she feels mighty. She thinks about it. She does have a mighty pull on the oceans of Earth. Maybe she is mighty. Luna has heard about the big families of the giant planets up past the asteroid belt. She knows that some of them have 80 or even more moons. She asks Earth if she can visit them. "I'd like to see what it would be like to live in a big family," she tells Earth. Earth agrees to send the Zoom spacecraft out so Luna can talk with the other moons. Beep, beep. "Zoom spacecraft, reporting for duty, moon mission. You can use me to talk to the other moons that are so far, far away. First up, Jupiter." Zoom speeds away past the asteroids, out to Jupiter and the many moons that orbit the big, gassy giant. Io is there with so many volcanoes. "Hello, Luna. There are many moons here and we are all marvelous. Have you met Europa?" Europa is there with an icy crust and a salty ocean underneath. "Hello, Luna. Do you know Ganymede?" "Ganymede is so big, like a planet themselves, even bigger than Mercury." "Hello, Luna. Would you like to meet Callisto?" "Callisto is old and tough and covered in craters." "Hello, Luna. There are more of us, too." More than 90 moons say hello. Luna feels a little overwhelmed. She tries to keep everybody straight, but there are so many moons, and they are all so different. She says to herself, "Moons are mighty. Moons are many. Moons are marvelous." Zoom spacecraft says, "Beep, beep. Next stop, more mighty, marvelous beep, moons." Beep. Zoom speeds to Saturn, and Luna can see that many of the moons of Saturn are bumpy and lumpy like asteroids, but some are round like her. There are more moons than letters in the alphabet. There's Atlas and Bailey, Calypso, Dione, Enceladus, Fenrir, Gerd, Helene, Iapetus, Janus, Carrie, Loge, Mimas, Narvi, Pandora, Rhea, Skoll, Titan, and Ymir. Titan is the biggest of these many moons. Some of the moons orbit in one direction and others orbit in another direction. Everyone is going around in a different way. It's so busy. Titan says, "Hello, Luna. Nice to visit with you. Tell us about yourself. Do you have an atmosphere and liquid like me?" "Oh no," says Luna, "I have rocks and some ice. My Earth has those things. It's very kind of you to ask about me." "Yes," says Titan, "it's always fun to meet another moon. We are a special type of object in the family of the sun. Aren't we magnificent moons?" "It's so nice to meet you," says Luna to Titan and all the others. Beep beep, Zoom spacecraft, moon mission. Next stop, beep, beep. Uranus. Luna meets the many moons of Uranus and they all love reading and stories. They're named after characters from stories that she has heard. There's Ariel, Juliet, Ferdinand. Ariel says, "Hello, Luna. Do you like stories?" Juliet says, "I love to tell stories." "Oh yes," says Luna, "I love to listen to stories. And sometimes we act them out. It's a fun thing to do when it's cold, says Ferdinand. Ariel says, stories make us merry. Luna says, yes, I feel very merry. Thank you. Luna thinks to herself, moons are mighty, moons are many, moons are marvelous, moons are magnificent, moons are merry. The Zoom spacecraft beeps, beep, beep. Last stop on the moon mission, Neptune. There are 14 moons around Neptune, and the biggest one is Triton. Triton is mysterious. Hello, Luna. I am covered in ice, and I also have volcanoes and geysers. Also, I started out in the Kuiper Belt before I lived with Neptune. Moons are mysterious. Luna tries to imagine starting out in a different part of the solar system and then orbiting Earth. Luna tries to imagine sharing her orbit with so many other moons. She thinks maybe being the only moon is not so bad after all. It's a comfortable place, a just right place for Luna. Luna is one mighty, marvelous, magnificent, merry, mysterious moon. It's craft time. Today we're going to make little moon mobiles. For this activity, you need a piece of white paper, scissors, your hole punch, a piece of yarn, something to draw with, like a colored pencil, and you'll also need a jar lid. The jar lid is what we're gonna use to make our circle. So what you're gonna do is just put your lid on the piece of paper and then trace around the circle. And when you do that, you should get a perfect circle. You'll need two of this for this activity. So go right ahead and trace around that jar lid one time and then another time to make two circles. Then you need to cut out those circles and just be sure that you're carefully cut around the whole circle. Make a really great round shape. Great! Now I did that already, so now I have two. And we're gonna use, you could just use the plain circle, but this is the way to make it three-dimensional. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut a little slit in that and then slide them together, and that's gonna make a three-dimensional shape. So to cut the slit, the first thing we're gonna do is find the center of our circle and put a little dot there. There we go. And then we're gonna draw a line from the center all the way out to the edge of the circle. That's great, right there, like that. And now we want to make this slot a little bit more than the center, so we're gonna extend that down just a tiny bit, just like that. And you're gonna need to do that for both of your circles. So find your center, draw your line, and then extend it down. Great. Now we have two circles and we're gonna cut our two slits. Just stay, same way, just staying on the line and cutting right along that line that we drew. This is practice of cutting scissors and being really careful. There, I did it. Now I'm gonna slide those two together and you'll see how it makes, instead of a one-dimensional circle, two-dimensional circle. We know the moon is not a flat disc, but really a round sphere. So this kind of gives that idea. Now you can decorate every side of this. You can flatten this again and just draw some different things on there. You might want to draw some craters on there and some round craters like this on each side of your moon. And you might want to think about other features that you might see on your moon. And remember that every side of your moon is going to show in this mobile. Now, just so this doesn't slide around too much, we're gonna add that little piece of scotch tape. So we're gonna tape it right here in between here. You can kind of flatten it to tape it. Just right there at the top. And then we're going to open it up again. And we can add another piece of scotch tape on the other side so that it doesn't slide around too much. Here's my tape. And just add on a piece of tape right to that, slide it out. Then you can open it up again, make sure that it keeps its shape. Now, we want to attach this. And to attach this, we're gonna put two holes at the top of our shape, our circle shape, with a hole punch, just like that. And then we'll have two places to thread our yarn through. And that will make it so that when it is a hanging, it hangs kind of nice and evenly. Gives you a good place to hang your moon from. All right, and then just slide that yarn right up, and there we go. There's our moon. Now, to make it into a mobile, you can just hang it up on something, but you can also attach it to a straw or a skewer. And here I actually put a straw on a skewer. And you can just slide it on there and loop it around one time so that it stays on there, just like that. And maybe you want to have one moon like the Earth has, or maybe you want to have two moons like Mars has, or you can make many, many moons for your mobile like Saturn or Jupiter has. There we go. That's our fun mobile. I hope you enjoyed this. If you like this activity, give us a like and thumbs up, and subscribe to our channel so that you'll get our craft times and story times in your subscription box each month. Thanks so much for joining us. Bye-bye.